Okay, Ana.
Srikar, you can start now.
Yes. Welcome to Virtual Assembly by Rockwoods. Good morning to our respected chairman, director, principal, headmistress, teachers, parents, and all my dear fellow Rockwoods. The whole world is facing this pandemic, but it is said that a collective prayer is very powerful and communicates a collective energy to overcome these difficult times. Let's pray fervently to the God Almighty to prevail over these tough times. Today, we have reached the sixth habit of Stephen Covey, the seven habits of highly effective people, which is to synergize. The essence of synergy is to value and respect differences, to build on strengths, and to compensate for weakness.
The sixth habit revolves around synergy. The best way to find a solution to the problems is by creating an environment where everyone can share their ideas with respect to their experience and expertise, so that one best possible solution can be picked out from the pool of ideas. It will be a far better approach because it helps to produce quality results with a combined effort instead of an individual giving the solution. Synergy is necessary to become a successful leader, to work collectively by overpowering all the challenges.
In order to achieve synergy, there are some essential elements that the team should possess. They must have similar goals. They should have a sense of cause above self. They stay open to new ideas. They should embrace trust. They should understand that the best to do things is by working together.
They show respect to each other. They must have the courage to apologize. They should have the aspiration to comprehend others. They should be capable of controlling the negative judgment. They must have trust in win-win instead of win-lose.
One of the key takeaways of synergy is that when you work together, then you can get the chance to share the ideas that others cannot think of. It ultimately helps you to find the best solution to the problem, which would never have been possible without synergy. Every person is different in their own way, and the potential of each can be leveraged only if the work environment is collaborative. When we synergize, we become more creative because one can take the best part of each of the team members' expertise to bring something more unique and innovative. Synergy helps to get things done faster because when we are working as a team, if one lacks any skill, the other team members is there to cover it up instead of working individually with a limited skill set.
Synergy also enables one to gather a pool of different ideas to work with. While the entire team is on the same page and working in the same direction, one is working at the luxury to choose the best solution to get problem fixed. Synergy helps one build an environment of 360 degrees feedback system where everybody has an equal opportunity to contribute and recommend. It also helps in building a healthy relationship among the team. This atmosphere brings trust and let others be open to discuss things.
Now, let us view the very old story from Panchatantra, where the birds synergize to save themselves from the hunter.
The Hunter and the Pigeons. A long time ago, there was a huge banyan tree which is home to the nests of many birds. One day, a hunter happened to come to the tree. Seeing that many birds lived there, he set up his net below the tree and scattered a few grains of rice to attract them. A flock of pigeons flying past the banyan tree saw the grains of rice and went down to eat them. Suddenly, a huge net fell over them and trapped them. They struggled to get out of it but couldn't. They could see the hunter walking towards them, looking delighted, having caught so many pigeons. The pigeons were distressed and thought the end was near. But the wise king of the pigeons had a plan and said,
"We should all fly up, carrying the net with us. Once we manage to get away from the hunter, we can think of what to do next."
The pigeons listened to their king's advice. Each pigeon held a part of the huge net in his beak and all of them flew up together. The hunter was amazed to see this happening. He tried to catch them, but they were too fast. The king of the pigeons knew a mouse who lived not far from there and could help them escape the net. Hearing his friend's voice, the mouse came out of his hole.
he saw the pigeons and their king trapped in the net and said,
"Oh, who did this? I will set you free right away."
He began to nibble the net nearest to the king, but the king stopped him and said, "Set my subjects free first. No king can see his subjects in pain and be free himself." The mouse nibbled off the net easily with his sharp teeth, and after freeing all the pigeons, he freed the king pigeon at last. The pigeons were very grateful to the mouse. They thanked him and flew away. This story proves that unity is strength.
I now request our principal, Ms. Lalita Naidu, to address this assembly.
Respected Chairman, Director, Headmistress, teachers, my dear students, very good morning to all of you. This beautiful habit of synergy is very important. Often, you know, we end up competing for nothing. One must compete with oneself and not with others. It is said, you know, that when the geese fly, they fly in a certain pattern, which is V-shaped. And that gives the geese the necessary impetus to fly fast. And when one goose gets tired, it moves back and the other comes in the forefront to lead. Okay, this shows, this is a beautiful example of synergy. And everywhere, you know, it is so important, whether it is in our classrooms, our way of functioning, in offices, in our governments, everywhere. You know, we all, it's said that the brain research says that, you know, everybody's brain works to the potential of about 10%. But if 10 people are working together, the amount will then become 100%. So therefore, synergy is very important. It is very important that we bring our skill sets. We don't keep our skill sets to ourselves. We don't hide it and we don't share it with others. Then it will remain with us. If you see all the inventions and all the discoveries that have been made, have been done with people giving their best and making it available to everybody in this world. So children, it's very important to synergize, and you people in a class, as a team, learn to synergize. Your performance will double and triple and grow exponentially. Thank you very much. Have a fantastic day.
Thank you, ma'am. May I now request the chairman, Mr. Raman Naidu, to address this gathering.
Good morning, all of you.
Good morning, sir.
Hope you're all doing the periodic test well. Today, let me talk about Stephen R. Covey's sixth habit, synergize. Synergize means innovate and problem solve with those who have different mindset and different point of view. To put it simply, synergize means two heads are better than one. Synergize is the habit of creative cooperation. It's a teamwork, open-mindedness, and adventure of finding new solutions to old problems. But it doesn't happen on its own. It's a process, and through that process, people bring all their experience and expertise to the table without any differences. Together, they can produce far better results than they could do individually. Synergy lets us discover things we are much less like to discover by ourselves. It is the idea the whole is greater than sum of its parts. 1 + 1 = 3 or 6 or 60, name it when you really work with synergy. Synergy is not the same compromise where 1 + 1 = 1.5 or even less than that. Synergy means 1 + 1 may be 200. When people begin to interact with each other genuinely and they are open to each other's feedback, they should be able to learn many more things, discover many more things in their life. Synergy is nothing but trusting the people around you, making sure that you learn from each other with experience and expertise, bringing to one another's experience. To introduce the synergy in our day-to-day life, I recommend all the students to find an accountability partner whom you can really trust, so that you would help your accountability partner how your day is going to be implemented. You share your day plan with a friend and ask your friend to share their day plan with you, so that both of you exchange your day plans and try to verify intermittently for every 2 hours, 1 hour, and start giving the feedback to each other, so that we can start taking the input from your friend and start staying focused on your task. That would help you to become more focused, and also someone is there to help you, to remind you on your day targets, so that by end of the day, you should be able to accomplish and achieve your goals. We have been seeing great results when you really have accountability partner for ourselves and even our teachers. I recommend all the students and also teachers to find accountability partner, either it's a personal work or a professional work or student work, so that we all work with synergy, and synergy should find many more things in our lives. It should be wholesome activity rather than some of its activity. I recommend all of you learn all these 6 habits and practice these 6 habits consciously. That would help you to become more effective, and you can find peace and harmony in your life, and also can give peace and harmony to the people around you. Thank you so much. Hope you do best in your other 2 exams too. Have a nice day.
Thank you, sir. Request you all to stand and sing a national song. I request you all to stay at home and stay safe. I request you all to join your respective online classes with your teachers. Thank you.